Okay, so this is one of my first crazy stories. This was the last time that I went to Rocks LA, just this past April of 2009. But it's in Los Angeles, what's in Glendale, a suburb of Los Angeles, and it's a Belly Dance Superstars event, and it's hosted by Marta Shill. But it is a wonderful event, so I go to it. I try to go every year since it started. But but every time I go, I stay in the same hotel. It's near a grocery store, and it's within walking distance of the venue, so it's just very conveniently located, as far as being in a place where I can get everything that I need and also be close to the venue. So this specific time that I went, so I always go a day early, so that way I can get acclimated and get used to the heat and the time difference being an hour ahead as opposed to an hour after. And then I go to the grocery store and I make sure to stock up on breakfast foods and fresh bottled water and making sure that I have all my foods for when I come back from taking workshops or performing or what have you. So, this last time that I went, I go into the hotel, I check in, drop everything off, and the first thing I do is I go to the grocery store. Sorry, the first thing I do is I turn on the news, so just to see what's going on in the neighborhood and get a feel and check out the weather and everything. And the first thing that they talk about is the swine flu. The swine flu was just breaking out in America. They were just talking about all the quarantines that were going on in Mexico, and they had the first cases reported in the United States. And of course, they're in the bordering states of Mexico, so there were a handful of cases in California. And I believe about half a dozen in Texas. So, right away, everyone is just in pandemonium over this epidemic. But it's the news, so of course it has to be sensationalist in order for them to get ratings. So I just kind of thought, okay, well, we'll just have to be careful around people who are sick and make sure that we don't come into close or prolonged contact with these people. So go to the grocery store, get all my stuff for my breakfast foods, and making sure that I have plenty of Gatorade and bottled water to take with me to take to my workshops and for the show. So I get that, and this hotel that I stay in, and it's in sort of Little Armenia, I guess you would say. It's all run by it's just a bunch of independent businesses run by Armenian families, and so there's restaurants and boutiques and little shops and what have you. Of course, there's the larger businesses like gas stations and fast food restaurants and of course the grocery store. But yes, there's just a bunch of independently owned and operated Armenian run businesses. So in most commercial places, I'm sure most people are familiar with the Cheesecake Factory. Well, in this neighborhood on the same block as where the hotel is where I stay, there's the Baklava Factory. And I have wanted to go there every single time that I go to Rocks LA or Tribal LA, because like I said, I stay in the same hotel. They're never open, ever open. To this day, I've yet to eat at the Baklava Factory. So I don't know, maybe it'll happen when I go back, but we'll see. So there's also another place that's there called Zanku Chicken, and I have heard nothing but good things about this place. So from people who live in Los Angeles, from people who have visited and just tried this place, they say that it is amazing. So I wanted to try this place, but they were closed. So I'm just thinking, okay, well, I have my groceries for breakfast and everything, but I just need some dinner, so let me just go. And they were closed. So I just figure, okay, well, let me just try one of these other places. There was a bakery, and I'm sure, and most bakeries, they also operate as delis. So I figured, okay, I'll just get a sandwich. So I go up to this Armenian bakery. It's closed too. So I'm just thinking, it's 5 o'clock on a Friday in Los Angeles. How come every place is closed? And I'm looking in more and more places. Closed, 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 closed. And I can't figure out why. So finally, I just get tired of finding a fi to find, an independent business to support. And I just say, screw it. So I go to the grocery store and I just get some dinner from the store. And also, I'm noticing that everywhere I go, there are the Armenian colors and Armenian flags. And I believe the number 206 was put on a lot of these items. So I get dinner from the grocery store and I turn on the news again. And come to find out, at this time they had elected a new president of Armenia. And in the early 1900s, there was a civil war between Turkey and Armenia. And during this time, the 206, apparently what that was represented by was the Turkish army took 206 Armenian soldiers prisoner and then killed them. So this at the time was believed to be a genocide, but with this newly elected president, he passed a bill saying that it was not genocide, it was actually an act of war. So Turkey was fighting with Armenia. Armenia was the enemy, so they took as many enemies as possible and eliminated the enemy. So since he passed this bill, so many of these Armenians were just incredibly upset. So they closed down their businesses and they went to go march on the Miracle Mile at the Turkish and the Armenian embassy because they were just so enraged by this. So there's riots going on, there's a swine flu breaking out, and I'm just trying to say, okay, I just got here. I'm just here to have fun and dance. I'm here to learn, I'm here to audition, I'm here to perform, and I'm here to, just meet new people and to meet some of my fans. So, and just to meet some of, and just meet up with some of my teachers and my friends. So, trying to make the most of this experience, just letting the swine flu and the riots fall to the wayside. So, Saturday rolls around, first day of workshops. And there's the show that evening. So I put on my nice Army Green Melodias, which I'm wearing today, and I put on a shirt and I pack up my backpack and I head on over to the venue. So I'm in the last block to get there. And I'm walking on the sidewalk and out from under this cart pops this little bird. And I'm looking close at it. It's a quail. And to be perfectly honest with you, I've not seen a quail in about 10 years since I've lived out on my little house out in the middle of the prairie. So yeah, my little house on the prairie. But I'm looking at this quail and it's looking up at me and I'm like, well, hello, little quail, you are just adorable. I've not seen one of you in so long. So it walks up to me and then it starts pecking at the toe of my shoe. And I say, okay, I'm gonna need for you to stop. And it won't stop. So I just start walking away and the quail keeps following me and pecking at my shoe. And I'm just talking to the quail like it's a person. I say, please stop, I don't wanna have to kick you. And it won't stop. So I start going at a soft jog. It starts flapping and using its talons to latch onto the tails of my Melodia pants. So finally, I'm just like, stop. And I just rattle my foot in its direction and it stuns it and it rolls over. And it just starts chirping and it won't stop. Just chirp, 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 chirp. Next thing I know, more quails come out from under these cars and they all start chasing me. I'm in Los Angeles trying to avoid the swine flu and the riots, and the next thing you know, I'm getting chased down by quails in the hood. I just wanted a belly dance.